Well, the main aim of the project was to understand and to gain knowledge on how we can use emotion measurement as a tool in combination with the sensory techniques to know more about beverage choice and consumption experience. One of the particularities of this project was that we wanted to make it as close as possible to a natural situation of experience of consumption. So we used in most of the studies a real context of consumption, a bar, and we also use a full sample size that we give to participants, to consumers. The project was divided in several studies, and we started to look at the conceptualizations of the beverage in studies, so the conceptualization of wine, beer, and non-alcoholic beer. And we did that in two different countries, so we did that in Portugal and also in the Netherlands. And from that study, we could define a lexicon, actually, of emotions that we could use for the beverages to be measured in the next stage of the project. After that, we look at the static measurement of emotions, so before consumption and after consumption, so that we could actually know what is the effect of consumption in what way it changed participants' emotions. And in the end of the project, we look at how emotions evolve dynamically, so actually during the experience of consumption. And for that, we use the dynamic sensory and dynamic emotional profiling. So one of the key results that industries they can use is that so it seems that successful products, they have a balance between the functional and emotional profile, which means that, for example, for companies that want to create a healthier version of a product, they of course have to look for of the functionalities. They need to focus on the functionalities, the healthiness part, and what they can communicate with that. But they shouldn't forget to look at the emotions and how that is communicated to consumers. That is the one of the key messages. Another one is that product name, it matters. So we could show that a single word, so the product name as beer or non-alcoholic beer, it could change the actual liking of a beverage, so during consumption or after consumption in this case. And also the product name can change how consumers feel after drinking, after consumption. I can give you an example. So when we give consumers a beer, but we say them that it was a non-alcoholic beer, the emotions in the end of consumption, they decreased. So they felt less positive emotions compared than when they were drinking the same beer. So and the main message here is that, to study food choice, to study beverage choice and experience of consumption, it's important that you look at the previous memories of consumption. So what is attached to the product name, so that you can understand actually what the effect will be in the experience of consumption. Another key message that we can attach to this, to the results of this project, is that when we look at the effect of the sensory characteristics of the ingredients, for example, adding hop aroma to a beer, we showed that can might have an influence in a certain specific part of consumption. Well, the third key message of this project is that actually we can have an interaction between the sensory and the sensory profile, dynamic profile, and also the emotion dynamic profile, and that can affect liking, or that can affect future choices. So we show that having hop aroma to commercial beer, actually the order of the emotions during consumption experience, they changed from negative to positive in the beginning of the consumption experience. Well, this this is an important finding because we know from other studies that consumption experience, depending on the part that it should attach it to certain emotions, that can have an influence in future choices. Okay, as a conclusion, we can say that for companies it is useful and it is an added value for product characterization and for food to study food choice and also experience of consumption. So to consider an integrative approach, combining emotion measurement, sensation measurement, and also liking. This is an added value.